Welcome to another session on Malayalam cinema. This is Tara Ravi Shankar, Assistant Professor in Department of Media Studies, Price Nagar College, Trivandrum. Welcome to our class once again. Premam was a trendsetter movie in Malayalam cinema. So many youngsters were inspired by Premam. The George who fall in love with his teacher, that was a big issue, a social issue in Kerala society, and people were talking about that. Anyway, George's friends, his dressings, everything was inspired by the black shirt, was inspired by the people in Kerala, and especially the youngsters. His first love was taken away by his namesake, and a second love meets with an accident and who gets him. And his third love is the young sister of her first love. That was the story of George. And it was Premam and Maheshinte Prathigaram. This is a very interesting movie because even the opening scene of Maheshinte Prathigaram is a very, it's a change happening in Malayalam cinema. You know, usually the Malayalam cinema starts with, even if you're watching Pakshe or all those films, you may see a establishing scene of a village or a landscape in a movie. But even in Jallikattu, you could see a long take in the opening scene. That means the Maheshinte Prathigaram was something different. You could see ഒരു ചെരുപ്പ് കഴുകുന്ന ഒരു സീനുണ്ട്. ആ ഒരു സാൻഡ്രസിനെ വാഷ് ചെയ്യുന്ന സീനാണ്. അതിന്റെ ഒരു എക്സ്ട്രീം ക്ലോസ് ആണ് അതിന്റെ ഒരു ഫിലിം. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഫോക്കസ് ഓൺ ഇറ്റ് പിൻ പോയിന്റ്സ് യു ടു ദ മെയിൻ എലമെന്റ് ഡിസ്കഷൻ ഇൻ ദ സിനിമ. ആൻഡ് മഹേഷിന്റെ ചെരുപ്പാണല്ലോ, അതിനകത്ത് ചെരുപ്പിടണോ വേണ്ടേ, എപ്പോ ചെരുപ്പിടും, ഇതാണല്ലോ മൂവിയുടെ ഒപ്പം. ആ ചെരുപ്പിനാണ് അവിടെ പ്രാധാന്യം. സോ ആ സാൻഡ്രസ് കാണിച്ചു നൽകുന്ന തുടങ്ങുന്നത്. ആൻഡ് മഹേഷ് ഇസ് എ സിമ്പിൾ ഫോട്ടോഗ്രാഫർ ഹൂ ലിവ്സ് ഇൻ എ സ്മോൾ ടൗൺ വിത്ത് ഹിസ് ഫാദർ. And his by the way of cinema, he is used not to wear slippers until he has revenge in the BT. And that was the Maheshinte Prathigaram and the Kamati Padam. Dulka broke out the mold of the cute boy next door to the cinema, Kamati Padam. Kamati Padam was a gangster movie with a pro Dalit approach. That was Kamati Padam. That was a notable critically acclaimed cinema. And you know about the so many other films like Drishyam and Pullimurugan, that is the blockbuster films. Pullimurugan, the gross success of the cinema, is a discussing topic. And you know about so many other films like notable films also, good for movies also came during this time. The pioneering film techniques in Malayalam cinema, I'm talking from the early 80s. I'm just going through whole cinema, just like a revision of what you have learned till now. And I'll start with the newspaper boy. That was happened in 1955. What was the speciality? It is the first Italian neorealistic influence cinema. That is the first neorealistic cinema in Malayalam. Then we have Padayota, the film with the first 70mm cinema. And My Dear Kutichathan was the first 3D cinema. Oh Fabi is the first live action animated cinema. And Amma Ariya, that was the first cinema made through an experiment. That means the bound by John Abraham, collecting woman Odessa, people's collective, they funded for the cinema. And the money was raised for the cinema. Then you have the money was raised by collecting donations and screening. The Charlie Chaplin's film was of that time. And Moonamudra, that was a trend-setting movie in Indian cinema because it was the first movie which was fully shot in digital, digitally shot and distributed cinema. That is Moonamudra, V.K. Prakash. V.K. Prakash was the director. And Jalachai, that was the world's first feature film shot entirely on a phone camera, Janachai, in 2000, phone camera. It was an experimental film by Sadish Kalathil, who is the director of Veena Vadanam, the first documentary film in Indian shot with the same movie capturing medium. And then about Villain, in 2017, the first Indian film to be shot in 8K resolution, Villain. Okay, then notable personalities in Malayalam cinema, you have G.C. Daniel, Ramu Kariyattu, Adoor Gopalakrishnan, G. Aravindan, John Abraham, P.A. Becker, I.V. Shashi, P.G. Vishwambaran, K.G. George, Bharathan, Padmarajan, Priyadarshan, I.V. Shashi, John Abraham, Fasil, Joshi, Bhadran, and so many. Cindy Malayal, Hariharan, Satyanandikada, K. Madhu, Siddiq. Siddiq Lal Kootagatta, then you have and the 2000 saw a decline in the quality of Malayalam films. That was what we discussed, and the coming up of Shakila Tarangam in Malayalam film industry, and these all things we have already discussed, and I told you about some of the plus directors of 2010 period, like Roshan Andrews, Blasi, Lal Cho, Samal Neeraj, Ashik Abu, Vini Srinivasan, Niju Jos Pallisheri, and along with that, you know, the actors like Shyama Prasad or Jayaraj were still in the scene. And you know, out of the 40 National Film Awards, the best directors, Adoor Gopalakrishnan was a notable film, and you know about Jayaraj, Aravindan, all these names are here. I'm just skipping all those things, and you have a detailed note on IFK here, and studios in Kerala. You know about the first Travancore National Pictures was the first film studio in Kerala. Which was the first film studio? Travancore National Pictures was the first film studio in Kerala. It was set by J.C. Daniel in Thiruvananthapuram. The 2 days, Pattam Big Bazaar was situated in this position. And later, Pattam Kalpana was there, and Pattam Kalpana, the space was occupied by Big Bazaar now. That was the history of Malayalam cinema is now in the form of a supermarket. And producer director Kunjaku and film distributor K.V. Koshi established Udaya Studio in Alappuzha in 1947. And that was a notable change happening. And you know about the Maryland set up by Subramanian. In Trivandrum, that was Maryland studio at Nema, and the major other studios were Sri Krishna in Kulathur 1952, Ajanta, Kirimeda, now it's not there, and Chitralega, Akulam, Uma studio was the studio set up by Madhu. Uma studio was actually, the earlier Uma studio was there at the Bulle Recording studio of Asianet, and Navodaya and Chitranjali is one of the prominent studios situated in Trivandrum, Thiruvallam. And the Association of Malayalam Film Artists, AMMA, you know, the productions, the organizations of film producers, they collectively form so many movements in Malayalam cinema. You know about the Malayalam, contemporary Malayalam film. Some of the missed films were Varadhan by Amal Neerad Varadhan. Varadhan is a horror film. We can't call it as a horror film because it's not actually horror. Varadhan, we can't call it a horror. It's not horror itself. It is an issue faced by a family in an isolated village. That was Varadhan. And you know, Brit Shines 1983. That was a beautiful film. People who love cricket may watch cinema. Not only cricket. I think the kind of sports and film hybridization was going on in all over India. You could see so many films like even Sachin, the docu fiction made in Indian cinema, and the next is like the Dhoni, the untold story. Again, you could see the like, so there's so many sports pictures were coming up in cinema. And 1983 was a notable cinema during that time. You know about the Dangal. All those films which were critically acclaimed, and then Kumbalangi Nights, that is another notable cinema. Then about Jellikattu, this Angamali Diary, Seema Yu, all these are films made by Niju Jos Pallisheri, which all went a huge success in international market. And you know about the Nayan, the science fi fantasy cinema. Then Android Kunyappan 5.35. It was a beautiful cinema with a character, robot being a character inside the cinema, a machine being a main character inside the cinema. Then Muthol by Gidu Mohandas, that was a trend setting movie Chola. Interesting cinema Thottappan, that is another interesting movie Thottappan. Then we have Sudani from Nigeria by Zakaria Muhammad. That was an interesting cinema where Shaubin with the main character. The narration style, the lighting, all these was very realistic. You could resemble it to any moments like Italian neorealism or French new wave. That was Sudani from Nigeria. The situation, the scenes, the mise-en-scene, the lighting, everything is very, very, very interesting. And I especially talk about the mise-en-scene concepts of Sudani from Nigeria. And we have Ida by Ajit Kumar, the Ajit Kumar. It was a modern day interpretation of Romeo and Juliet, two lovers, Anand and Aishwarya, who was from Kannur, where the influence of party was that much. And Uyere, Manu Ashogan, that was a sensitive drama about Pallavi Parvati, did the main character Parvati Tiruvotha. Why she fly? That was a question raised in the square cinema Uyere. And then we have Varane Avishamunda by the next genre, the next category of filmmaker Anoop Sathyan. Anoop Sathyan is the son of Sathyan Andikada. Anoop Sathyan came up with a movie that is Varane Avishamunda, where again pairing Suresh Gopi and Shobhana came up in the scene. We were very interested to watch them on the screen also. When we could see Kalyani Priyadarshan, who was the daughter of Priyadarshan and Lizzie, was on screen, and Dulkar Salman. And then you have Vikirthi, MC Joseph. Vikirthi, again, the South Indian cinema, was a notable cinema. And Suraj Venyaramudu did the main character. You know that Suraj Venyaramudu was a notable person for a few years. That means he got a national award too. Just like Salim Kumar also. Salim Kumar is another person. They were from the comedian category, and they moved to prominent characters, supporting characters. Then they came to the lead roles. That was a transition happening in Malayalam cinema. The caucus around the superstars or the stardom was all in a different way in Malayalam cinema now. And now the people who were doing the lead character in one cinema may be doing a supporting character in another cinema. So no such ego clashes were going on now. People were ready to watch any cinema. And next, Trance by Anwar Rishi was another psychological drama that was interesting. The main character was done by Fahad Fasil. And you have Ayyappan and Koshi by Sachi. We missed Sachi because he passed away in the sad demise. As a very touching situation, and both Ayyappan and Koshi, right? Ayyappan and Koshi, the main characters in cinema. Ayyappan was done by Biju Menon, and Koshi was done by Prithviraj, and that was Ayyappan and Koshi. Then we have Virus by Ashik Abu, based on Nipah virus issue, and that was Virus. Then we have already talked about Charlie, right? Then Helen, Mathukutty Xavier. Helen was an interesting movie. Helen, this cinema could freeze us even in the heights, right? It was Helen. The main character was by Anne Ben. Then Lucifer. Lucifer was directed by Prithviraj Sukumaran, a very popular actor in Malayalam cinema industry. Superstar that was Prithviraj Sukumaran. And you have Unda, Mammootty, with a new generation cinema, that is Unda by Karl Brahma. And that was an interesting cinema about a Maoist territory and armed forces facing issues there. And Joseph by M. Padma Kumar. That was a very, really interesting crime thriller movie, Joseph. And we have already talked about Jellikattu by Vijay Subbarajan, right? And I have to talk a little on this OTT platform. Actually, it was there in Kerala, in Malayalam cinema. You know, OTT was through Amazon, through Netflix. It was gaining a prominence all this time for the last few years. But still, by the outbreak of this corona 19, definitely COVID 19, people were more forced to watch OTT platforms, and this became a very powerful medium by itself. But during the lockdown, that was from March 28 midnight, all over India was stuck inside the houses and where they were, and definitely they were forced to watch all these things for entertainment. And digital medium emerged as an alternative to cinema, that means the cinema halls, conventional cinema halls during this pandemic. And Aditi Rao Haigure's Soofiyum Sujathi was the first major Malayalam movie to opt for a director OTT platform, OTT premium movie in Malayalam. And soon we could see the cinema, the computer or mobile screen cinema, See You Soon. That was an interesting cinema, right? See You Soon was a trendsetter. And we could see Halal Love Story by Indrajit, and Malayalam dubbed versions of Penguin and Asura Reporter. Talking about See You Soon, that was primed by Amazon Prime. That was a trendsetting movie. Mahesh Narayan directed the movie, and See You Soon, where Fahad Fazil was the main character. And at 90 minutes, the running time, the cinema was amazing. That means See You Soon was a suspense drama. The main speciality is the kind of making done for the cinema. The cinema actually it was shot from inside. The title card of the cinema shows like this: the film helped to provide wages for a bunch of workers whose only source of income was from cinema. You know, in many times when science cinema spikes and all going on, we were talking about the people who depend on cinema for their living. Okay, and that was the concern for making this See You Soon. That means we will be back to theater soon. That was the inner meaning of the title given. And the production broke most conventional rules of making films. And lead characters and producer Fahad Fazil turned his two apartments in Kochi into office and set for the cinema. And the producer home cook double as film owner chef and fed the crew. And there were no assistants fetching water or providing makeup for the actors. That was a new kind of film. See You Soon. And now about the new releases, you have now about the Aruji with a notable cinema, and that was where the Prithviraj is doing the main character with Amala Paul. Marakkar, a huge big budget film, was waiting for the release in 2021. They were just waiting for a good launch. And where Dalitan superstar, the lady superstar Manju Vaid are doing the lead characters. And The Priest, this was a real buzz made by Mammootty with Manju Vaid. And Niral, powerhouse performer by Nayanthara, will be seen in Niral, where the Kunjaka woman is leading the main character. Then Kurup and the film Malik, another movie. Malik again from Mahesh Narayan, a third collaboration with Fahad Fazil. Take off that See You Soon, all the previous movies. And the COVID-19 and the COVID-19 threats on lockdown, how it impacted Malayalam cinema. That is what I have discussed now. That means releasing movie on OTT platform, that was a bomb actually to Malayalam film industry. Around 10 Indian movies in various languages, including Malayalam, raised digital or a global digital premium. That was happening during this time, and people have now become accustomed to work from home. Expert think they would soon get used to have a unique cinema experience at their home, and by watching cinema through their mobile. Because we know that over these years, the concept of big screen was now changed, the mini micro screens. We are happy in watching movies in our mobile phones. And we are once we think how we could enjoy a cinema without having a popcorn or sitting in dark. But now people know that you could watch cinema, you could enjoy cinema even from a mobile phone, your micro space. And that was a new trend setting that is happening in Malayalam cinema, right? And movies like Forensic, that was released just 7 days back to this COVID-19 lockdown. they're struggling actually. And once Priyadarshan told, if I would release this, I would have released this in Marakyar just before the COVID pandemic situation, what would be the situation? The producer, they will suffer a lot. How could they gain the get that money back? That was a question. Kapela, all these are the five movie which faced the crisis. This foreign say Kapela, all these movies were really challenged by this lockdown. And even the Prithviraj Aiyappan and Koshi, the Varane Avishamunda, were all running in theater during that time. And big budget movies waited for theaters to reopen. And now by January 5, the government, in January 5, 2021, government of Kerala allowed the theater association to reopen their theater with a minimal number of half of the sitting capacity. And producers are now looking for OTT release also parallel to multiplexes. And multiplexes definitely they are facing the issue. Now about certain film festivals, you know about the coming up of International Film Festival in this new pandemic situation. It is going to be screened in several multiple cities. And again in Trivandrum, it is going to happen in between February 12 and February 19. And so many films like Lijo's Chiruli, Jairaj Hasyam was going to be screened. That means in competition, international competition section. And 12 films which have been selected in Malayalam cinema today is also there. Grama Vrikshathile Koyil, then See You Soon from by Mahesh Narayan, Santoshinte Onnam Rahasyam by Don Palathara. Then you have Love by Khalid Rahman. Then you have Musical Chair by Vipin Atli. Then Attention Please by Jitin S. K. Thomas. And Walk by Kavya Prakash. Paga, that was by Nitin Lukos. Then Tingalaisha Nischayam by Sena Hedge. And Pabam Chayatavar Kallariyate, that was by Shambhu Purushottaman and Roli Kunyapan. Then Danwar Kunjapan by Radish Balakrishnan Puduwal. Then Kayatam by Sanal Kumar Shashidharan. Then six films have been selected in Kaleidoscope category also, and two among them were Malayala films. One is Madhya Thiruvidangoor by Don Palathara and Biryani by Sajin Babu. Movie theatres in Kerala to open on January 5th with 50% occupancy. Drishyam 2 is waiting for that. By Jitu Joseph Liberty Brashear, the president of Kerala Film Exhibitors Association, they were not happy with the situation. They were waiting for the government to make some changes in the tax and all, entertainment tax and all. Film theatres in Kerala have been closed since March 10, days ahead of the national lockdown, that is on 20th March. The state government allowed film shooting to resume by June, or based on some restrictions, but we know the decisions were not going on. And you know, the situation of Malayalam cinema is now changed a lot. The technology, the kind of filmmaking, the new cinema now is being edited online. That means the editor is their location. Once we have heard that, we have studied that it is going on in the post-production stage, the editing. But now, along with the production, the editor is being on the location and he is editing the scenes just after the capturing of the scene. That means immediately after. നമ്മളെ പണ്ടൊക്കെ ഞാൻ എൻ്റെ ഒരു എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ് പറയുകയാണെങ്കിൽ, ആദ്യ കാലത്ത് ഞാനൊക്കെ അഭിനയിക്കുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് വി ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് ഡിജിറ്റൽ ക്യാമറ സോ വി ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് എൻ ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റി ടു വാച്ച് വോട്ട് വി ഹാവ് പെർഫോംഡ് ജസ്റ്റ് നൗ. അത് നമുക്കത് കാണാനുള്ള ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റി പോലുമില്ല. വി ഹാവ് ടു വെയിറ്റ് ടിൽ ദ പോസ്റ്റ് പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ. അവിടെ വൺസ് എഡിറ്റിംഗ് സ്റ്റുഡിയോയില് കഫ്കട്ട് കഴിയുമ്പോൾ ദേ മേ അലോ അസ് ടു സീ ദ സീൻ അറ്റ് ദ ടൈം ഓഫ് ഡബിങ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾ. ബട്ട് ഇന്ന് നമുക്ക് കുറച്ചുകൂടെ കഴിഞ്ഞ് വന്നപ്പോൾ ഡിജിറ്റൽ ഇയർ വന്നപ്പോൾ ബൈ 2010 നമുക്ക് ആർട്ടിസ്റ്റുകൾക്ക് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ടെക്നീഷ്യൻസ് ദേ കുഡ് വാച്ച് ദ സീൻ സൈമൾട്ടേനിയസ്ലി, ദേ കുഡ് ഗെറ്റ് എൻ ഔട്ട് ഫ്രം ദ ക്യാമറ ആൻഡ് അവർക്ക് അത് കാണാൻ പറ്റും. അവർക്ക് അവരുടെ വ്യൂ ഫൈൻഡറിലൂടെ തന്നെ ദേ കുഡ് വാച്ച് ഇറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദേ കുഡ് ഹാവ് എ സെപ്പറേറ്റ് മോണിറ്റർ ഫോർ ഒബ്സർവിംഗ് ഓൾ ദി സീൻ. ആൻഡ് നൗ വാട്ട് ഇസ് തിങ് വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പനിങ് ഇസ് ദേ ആർ എഡിറ്റിംഗ് ദ സീൻ, ഫുൾ സീൻ. ആ സീൻ റഫ് കട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നു, എടുക്കുന്ന സീൻസ് റഫ് കട്ട് ചെയ്ത് ആ സീൻ എങ്ങനെ ഇരിക്കും എന്നൊരു റഫ് ഇമേജ് കൊടുക്കുകയും ആൻഡ് ദേ ഹാവ് എ ചോയ്സ് ടു ഇംപ്രൂവൈസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇഫ് ദേ നീഡ് ആ ഒരു ചാൻസ് വേണമെങ്കിൽ അത് ഇംപ്രൂവൈസേഷൻ വരെ പോസിബിൾ കാരണം ബിക്കോസ് ആ ലൊക്കേഷനിൽ നിന്ന് മൂവ് ചെയ്യുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് തന്നെ അവർ ആ സീൻ ആസ് എ ഹോൾ ഒന്ന് റഫ് ചെയ്ത് കാണുകയാണ് അത്രമാത്രം ചേഞ്ചസ് ആൻഡ് ടെക്നോളജി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഇൻ ദ കേസ് ഓഫ് ഡി ഐ ഇൻ ദ കേസ് ഓഫ് കളർ കറക്ഷൻ യു നോ അബൌട്ട് ദ സിനിമ യൂബിന്റെ പുസ്തകം ദാറ്റ് വാസ് ഹിസ് ഫിലിം വിച്ച് ഡിഡ് എ ലോട്ട് മെനി എക്സ്പെരിമെന്റ്സ് വിത്ത് എ കളർ കറക്ഷൻ യൂബിന്റെ പുസ്തകം ഡോണ്ട് മിസ് ഇറ്റ് യൂബിന്റെ പുസ്തകം ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് വാസ് എ വണ്ടർഫുൾ സിനിമ ആൻഡ് യു നോ സം ഫിലിം മേക്കേഴ്സ് ലൈക് ഹൂമി പുള്ളി മുരുകൻ ആൻഡ് ഓൾ the filmmaker was experimenting the colors he was making in Cousins all these films he was using colors in cinema and that was such filmmakers were also there and you know comedy suspense thrillers crime thrillers or horror cinemas you know about the Esra which came up റീസെന്റ് എസ്ര എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഈ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ ഒരു ന്യൂ ജോണർ ഓഫ് ഹൊറർ സിനിമയായിരുന്നു സോ എല്ലാതരം സിനിമയ്ക്കും ഒരു ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റി ഒരു സ്പേസ് ഉള്ള ഒരു കാലഘട്ടമാണ് ഇന്ന് മലയാള സിനിമ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ പൊസിഷൻ ഓഫ് മലയാളം സിനിമ ടുഡേ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ആൻഡ് ടെക്നോളജി അലോങ് വിത്ത് ദ ടാലന്റഡ് ആർട്ടിസ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് യു നോ സോ മെനി ടാലന്റ്സ് ഈവൻ ബിഫോർ ദ ക്യാമറ ആൻഡ് ബിഹൈൻഡ് ദ ക്യാമറ ന്യൂ കമേഴ്സ് ആർ കമ്മിങ് ടു ദ സീൻ ദേ ആർ കമ്മിങ് വിത്ത് ന്യൂ തീംസ് the kind of film making the kind of thoughts they introduce everything was new so people love watching cinema they want to go back to cinema the multiplexes the influence of multiplexes is another important thing because when multiplexes came up people find cinema as a part of their entertainment that means a session of their entertainment they could have food they could have some bustles they could enjoy in the park everything is going on simultaneously and you could get a pizza instead of a popcorn even popcorn is very popular still popcorn in a new genre right popcorn still in a variety of taste sandwich that is going on in our multiplexes and eating or watching cinema what is going on I don't know and the kind of seating the relaxed chairs the executive seating is where really interesting you could sleep and watch the cinema that was something different what we could see in cinema തറക്കേറ്റെടുത്ത് കഷ്ടപ്പെട്ട് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എന്താ പറയുക ബാൽക്കണിന്നൊക്കെ ഉള്ള കൺസെപ്റ്റേ പോയി നമ്പർ ഓഫ് സീറ്റ്സ് തന്നെ ഹൺഡ്രഡ് ലിമിറ്റഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള സീറ്റ്സ് അപ്പം അവിടെ ബാൽക്കണിന്ന് ഒരു കൺസെപ്റ്റ് ഇല്ല ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് പീപ്പിൾ ഡോണ്ട് നമ്മളൊരു ഈഗോ ഇഷ്യൂസ് ഒന്നുമില്ല പണ്ട് ബാൽക്കണിക്ക് താഴെ നല്ലൊരു ഫാമിലി മെമ്പേഴ്സ് സീറ്റ് കിട്ടിയാലും എടുക്കത്തില്ല ബട്ട് നൗ ഇങ്ങനെ ഒന്നും പ്രശ്നമില്ല നമുക്ക് ഏറ്റവും ഫ്രണ്ടിൽ പോയാലും ഇഫ് യു റിയലി ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ടു വാച്ച് സിനിമ യു മേ വാച്ച് ദ സിനിമ അങ്ങനെ ഒരു കൺസെപ്റ്റിലേക്ക് സിനിമ ഹോൾസ് മാറി ആൻഡ് നമ്പർ ഓഫ് സിനിമയുടെ ഷോസ് നമ്പർ ഓഫ് ഫിലിംസ് മാറി നമ്പർ ഓഫ് റിലീസസ് മാറി വേൾഡ് വൈഡ് റിലീസസ് സോ ഇനിഷ്യൽ കളക്ഷൻ ഹാസ് ഗിവൻ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻസ് ആദ്യത്തെ ദിവസം തന്നെ ഒരുപാട് കളക്ട് ചെയ്യുക ആൻഡ് പണ്ടത്തെ പോലെ 100 ദിവസവും 200 ദിവസവും ഓടുന്ന സിനിമകൾ ഇന്നില്ല അതൊക്കെ വെറും കെട്ടുകാഴ്ചകൾ മാത്രമായി ആൻഡ് സിനിമ ഈസ് മൂവിംഗ് ഇൻ എ ന്യൂ പേസ് സ്റ്റിൽ വി ആർ എക്സ്പെക്ടിങ് ആൻഡ് മൂവ് ഓൺ മോർ ആൻഡ് മോർ സിനിമ മോർ ആൻഡ് മോർ ഡിഫറൻസസ് ഇൻ സിനിമ മോർ ആൻഡ് മോർ വെറൈറ്റീസ് ഇൻ സിനിമ ഇൻ 2021 ഓൺവേർഡ്സ് And when talking about Malayalam cinema in general, when I am concluding, definitely I have to talk a little. That means the chronological history of cinema, the history, growth and development of cinema, this is what we were discussing. And definitely the main reason for the sense of gratification viewers experienced in Malayalam cinema is what we given importance in this period. And you know about the considerable changes that were happening in cinema. Initially we start with the social themes, then we move on to some Italian neorealistic trends and even new wave trends, and then we come to the classifications like art cinema or parallel cinema, then middle cinema and the commercial cinema or mainstream cinema. And by 80s, 90s we call them golden age of Malayalam cinema. With so many mainstream cinemas, so many notable directors. Malayalam cinema gained its popularity in international level through so many films. If I forget to mention any name, you kindly Satish Menon's Bhavam or Sanjay Nambiar's Yanam, Liji Pullapulli's Sanjaram, Murali Nair's Arimvara, Marana Simhasanam, പട്ടിയുടെ ദിവസം ഓൾ ദീസ് വേ നോട്ടബിൾ ഫിലിംസ് ഇൻ മലയാളം സിനിമ ശ്യാമപ്രസാദ്, നോട്ടബിൾ ഡയറക്ടർ മലയാള സിനിമ, ഒരേക്കടൽ, അകലെ, ഇംഗ്ലീഷ്, എം പി സുകുമാരൻ നായർ, കഴകം, ആൻഡ് ദെൻ വി കെ പ്രകാശ്, സോമിൻ, നോട്ടബിൾ ഫിലിംസ് ആർ ശരത്, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ നോട്ടബിൾ ഫിലിം മേക്കർ ആർ ശരത്, ഭൂമിയുടെ ചരമഗീതം, ആൻഡ് സായാഹ്നം, ദെൻ പ്രിയനന്ദനൻ സിനിമ, നെയ്ത്തുകാരൻ, പുലിജന്മ, ഓൾ ദീസ് വേർ നോട്ടബിൾ ഫിലിംസ് ഇൻ മലയാളം. യു നോ അബൌട്ട് ദ ഫിലിംസ് ലൈക്ക് അമൽ നീരസ് ബിഗ് ബി ഓർ സാഗറേലിയസ് ജാക്കി, ദെൻ കീർത്തി ചക്ര, ദ മേജർ റവി ഫിലിംസ്, കീർത്തി ചക്ര, മിഷൻ 90 ഡേയ്സ്, കുരുക്ഷേത്ര, ആൻഡ് ദെൻ മധു കൈതപ്രം, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് അനദർ ഏകാന്തം ആൻഡ് ഓൾ ഹി മേഡ് സോ മെനി നോട്ടബിൾ ഫിലിംസ്, മധു കൈതപ്രം. And about when studying about Malayalam cinema over this long age of long history, definitely soon it is going to celebrate this 100 years, right? Because it started only in 1928, and by 2028 it is going to celebrate the 100 years of Malayalam cinema. That is the history of Malayalam cinema. That means you have so many things you are learning through this. We have studied so many things. We have studied the characteristics of cinema. We have discussed the nature of cinema till 2021. I hope my kids have got a brief idea about Malayalam cinema. I again mentioned that term brief idea because Malayalam cinema is much more to be detailed than what I detailed in these few hours. So definitely go and search more on cinema or cinema. Definitely by watching only you could get a clear idea of what is the real history of Malayalam cinema. Thank you for listening to me. Here, signing off, your teacher, Tara Ravishankar.